I'm Tammy Calda, an applied mathematician, and this is Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. In today's episode, I'll talk about drawing angles and triangles using TikZ. This idea was suggested by a watcher, so thanks for the input. I'm making this video as self-contained as I possibly can, but I urge you to check out some of my other videos, especially the introductory ones, if this doesn't make sense. The videos on this channel are based on my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, as well as some bonus materials. Our focus today is on drawing angles and triangles. Here is the preamble for the document that we'll create. The first group of packages are just conveniences. Parskip and FullPage make things look nice, while HyperRef enables me to link the author name back to the channel. The essential package is TikZ. Today we'll be using the Angle TikZ library, which is key for drawing and labeling angles. Before we create any triangles, let's start with just drawing an angle. I'll paste here a TikZ picture where I have drawn an orange line connecting three points A, B, and C. Let me walk you through the details of what I'm doing here. I start with an explicit coordinate 0, 1. I'm giving this coordinate a name by saying the command coordinate and then the A following in parentheses. I'm also doing something that I haven't shown you previously, which is adding a label to the coordinate via the label equal position colon label option. Here I specify that the placement is left and the label text is A in a math font. I use the dash dash to indicate a line to operation, which I connect to the explicit coordinate 3, 0. I label that point B using the same mechanisms as I use to label the point A. Finally, I use another line to operation to connect to the explicit point 6, 2, which I label as coordinate C. The result over here, you can see I have A, B, and C, and then conveniently, because you kind of lose track of what's what, I have them labeled with their names A, B, and C as well. Now we use the magic provided by the Angles TikZ library to draw our angle. I'll add a special incantation of sorts with this command slash pick with the option draw. And then I'm specifying angle equals C dash dash B dash dash A in curly braces. So picks are a general concept in TikZ. An angle is a specific type of pick with three arguments indicating the angle that should be drawn. The direction of the angle always extends from the right side if you are walking from the first point to the second. So if I'm walking from C to B, the angle will come out that right side. So if I instead had specified A, B, C, the angle would be drawn around the outside. If I didn't use this draw option, I wouldn't have seen anything when I created the pick. So be careful about that. I'll also note that this is dash dash, not a single dash. I always get that wrong when I first create this. So try to be careful and use dash dash instead of just dash. By default, the distance of this angle out here, so with long this distance and this distance, is 5 millimeters. We can change that with the angle radius option. So here I'm going to specify an explicit distance of 3 millimeters. So look at it now, and then after I recompile it, that angle is now only 3 millimeters away. We can also add a label to the angle. The option pick text specifies what the text should be. Here I'm using the mass symbol theta. When I compile that, we have our theta, but it's a little bit awkwardly placed. So let me show you how to adjust that. The final option adjusts where that angle label is put relative to the arc. This is a multiplier, not an explicit distance like 3 millimeters. So by default, this multiplier is 0.5, and we're going to change it. So the name of this thing is angle eccentricity. By default, it's 0.5. We're going to change it to 1.5. If it were 1, the node that contains our text would be centered exactly in the middle of our angle arc. So now you know the three important keys for the angle pick. Angle radius specifies how far out the line is drawn. Pick text specifies the label text. And angle eccentricity specifies how far out to put the label as a multiplier for the angle radius. Now that we know how to create an angle, let's set about labeling angles in triangles. Let me first go ahead and paste some code to draw a triangle that we could see over here. The draw command is creating the triangle with coordinates at 0, 3, 0, 0, and 2, 0, labeled A, B, and C, respectively. Observe that I've also added some labels to the sides of this triangle. I've added an X midway along the line from A to B. So here's A, here's B. I have my dash dash, and I have node midway, and then I put it to the left. Likewise, I've added a Y midway on the line between B and C. And finally, I've added the word hypotenuse midway between C and A. I also remind you, if you don't remember from prior episodes or you haven't watched them, that the cycle command connects back to the first point. Next, let's label the angles at A and at C. For the angle at A, we're going to start at B and then go to A because that will have the angle on the right side. For the angle at C, we start at A, and then as we're walking along, this angle will be on our right side as well. Let me compile that and you'll see what happens. We've drawn here the angles in cyan. We've specified to make the lines that we draw thick, and then we are making the angle eccentricity, which says how far out the label should go, to be 1.4, and then we specify the text of alpha and beta for the two angles respectively. These are using the default angle radius of 5 millimeter. I haven't made any change to that. There is a special pick for right angles that works the same as the angle pick, except that it draws a little square. So this is really nifty. So the angle at B is a right angle. So let's paste our right angle pick. So here the arguments are the same. We have angle radius and 3 millimeters. And rather than just angle, we're saying right angle. And the result over here is that we've drawn a little square. So now we have a fully labeled triangle. The last thing I want to show is how to create a triangle with a specified angle without pre-computing where all the coordinates are. We can use polar coordinates along with the turn option to do this. And I would encourage you to go back and watch some of my other episodes on polar coordinates, which can show you some other things that you can do. Let me first set things up. I'm going to draw a picture where I have a line from A to B, and I want to create another point C that is a distance of 3 from the point B and at an angle of 45 degrees relative to this line from A to B. So I want to create a 45 degree angle in here. What I can do is use this thing called the turn options. Let me paste some code here. I want to create an angle of 45 degrees. So I have to say that I'm going to turn 135 degrees. That's because I have a line that goes from A to B, and that corresponds to the angle 0. And so 45 degrees inside my triangle would mean going 135 degrees relative to that line from A to B, where that corresponds to the angle 0. So now we have that 45 degree angle, and then we've drawn a line of distance 3. So this is using relative polar coordinates, making a turn. And then I went ahead also and labeled that edge to show that its distance is 3. Finally, I can finish my triangle with a cycle back to the first point, and I'll label that edge X. Before I label my angles, I want to create a style that I can use to make it a little easier, so I don't have to specify a whole bunch of stuff every time. So I'm creating a style called ANG or ANG, and I'm specifying that that style will draw the angle. It'll set the angle eccentricity to 1.5, and it will take an argument to specify the text that gives the label for the angle. Now that I have that, I can actually go ahead and draw my angles. So I'll go ahead and draw all three angles using my special style. So I say ANG equals 45 degrees for the angle at B, and then I also draw my other angles that I'm labeling alpha and gamma on the inside of this triangle. Using this style saved me a lot of extra typing. Now we have a classical problem in trigonometry of finding the distance x in angles alpha and gamma when you're given two sides and one angle of the triangle. I hope you found today's episode on drawing angles and triangles helpful. If you did, please click like or subscribe. If you have TikZ or PGF plots questions, please post them in the comments and I'll see what I can do. If you want to learn more, please check out the other videos. I also have a book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, available for purchase at major book retailers. Thanks for watching.